Okay, good evening to everyone. Welcome back to Panda Key Learning. Hope I'm audible. So please check with my voice whether I'm audible or not. Okay. So I will increase my voice. Now you can check with my voice. Yeah, okay. So good afternoon to everyone. So welcome back to Panda Key Learning. Today we will discuss about how we are using a image processing in a MATLAB. We have different platforms. We can discuss each and everything. So now I can start the procedure. So actually in Pantex, so we are providing a different formats. Like, so we are providing internships, workshops, and we are giving a information to the R&D people and research and development people for PhD people. And we are providing many and major projects. So thanks for giving this opportunity from Pantex. I'm very happy to share this information with you. So hope this information will be useful to you. So this session is conducted by, this webinar is conducted by Annamacharya Institute of Technology and Sciences. So Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering. So we have a webinar on image processing using MATLAB. So our convener is Dr. M. Subbarao and Dr. C. H. Nagaraju, and coordinators are Dr. K. Riyazuddin and G. Tirumalaya. Sir, thank you, sir. Thanks for giving this opportunity. And we have a chief patrons. So thanks to all people. Thanks for giving this wonderful opportunity. So hope all people will enjoy the session. So if you have any questions in between the session, you can raise your questions in chat box. It will helpful to your information when you're getting some information. So that should be in a informative format. Okay. If you're not understanding this, so there is no use. So just listen properly and hope it will get better. You can get a much more information about the image processing. Thank you. So now I can start the session. So why we are using this image processing and what is this image processing, each and everything I will tell you. So don't worry about the information. So basically, we can see before going to this application, actually in this, by using image processing, we are taking one application here, okay, image processing based. So we want to identify the COVID-19 disease by using a deep learning technology in MATLAB. Okay, the main part is when you are starting this process, first, so the application is here, COVID-19 disease detection, but platform is MATLAB. And which type of content you are using here, that is image processing. So based on image processing techniques with the deep learning algorithms, so we are just applying all those things in MATLAB with the application of COVID-19. So we should know about each and everything, okay? If you are fourth year people, you know very well about the image processing. If you don't know about the image processing, don't get stressed. So I will explain all those things, how we are using that parts. So each and everything I will explain to you, don't worry. Okay. So first we should know about the concept, application. What application we are using here, the COVID-19. First you want to know what is the COVID-19 and how we are getting the problems with the COVID-19. What is the problem statement, like what is the problem, which type of problems we are getting in COVID-19 and how we'll rectify. And if you're not rectifying also, definitely we should go with at least minimum solution. So we want to give a solution to identify the COVID-19 people. So within a less time, the main thing is, so within a less time, we want to get a more output. Okay, we want to satisfy more within less time. So that purpose, we are just going with here, the application is COVID-19. Here, what is the problem? So nowadays, you can see we are getting a lot of patients, right? Like we have a lot of cases in India or worldwide also, okay? So nowadays, it's little bit low because of people know aware of this COVID-19. So that's why they're taking some suggestions from another people. So that's why some little bit is there, but we are getting a lot of problems with the persons, whether that are affected with the COVID-19 exactly or not, we can't able to find out that persons. So that's why we're just going this one. And in COVID-19 detection, what we are doing and what is the use of this COVID-19, each and everything I will tell you. So then we can go with the processor of MATLAB, how we are using a MATLAB in this COVID-19 application, we can see. Okay, so here the main thing is in COVID-19 detection. So what are the symptoms? First we should know the symptoms, then only we can see whether the person is affected with the COVID or not, right? So if you want to go with the test also, first, if you have a symptoms, then we can say we can take test, whether that is a RT-PCR or scanning test. Okay, so here, so you should know the symptoms. What are the symptoms, main symptoms for the COVID-19? I think you people know very well about this information. So fever, fatigue, so headache, dry cough, okay, breathing of body aches. So if you are getting normally, if you are getting 1 or 2 days fever, that's okay, fine. But continuously, if you are getting a fever and you are getting very low, you are like a weak, you are very strong fellow before some days, but you are not strong at that. You can't stay and you can't sit, you can't stand, and you are getting much more headache and you are getting a pains in your bodies and you can't speak more. Okay, you are getting sometimes problems of with breathing also, you can't get breathing. So sometimes you are getting cough also, okay? So 1 or 2 times means okay, but if you are getting continuously, definitely we can say that person is, that are the symptoms of COVID-19, okay? So if you are getting these symptoms, so first you should check with the test. Okay, so before going to that, so how many people are, what is the status of COVID-19? So here we can check all those things. So you can see, based on this diagram, you can say directly, okay. So 80% of people are not affecting with the COVID. If they are affecting also, they are recovering without any. Treatment, because they have a much more immune power. Okay, so that's why. So they are recovering very easily comparing with the other people. Okay, so now you can see. And the second thing is, second part is, 50% people are affected with the COVID-19 and they're getting very serious, because so if they have any problems with the, like, health issues. Okay, if they're getting any health issues, if they have already the health issues, so that people are affecting very high, and they're getting some problems with the oxygen also. Okay, so just to recover the, just recycle the each and everything. Okay, so from past 6 to 7 months onwards, we have some problems with the oxygen also, right? So some people are donated the oxygens also, oxygen bar. Oxygen things, right? So here the main thing is, why the 50% people are affected means maybe the negligency, and if they have already the problems of health issues, they are getting highly. Okay, and next one is, here it's very dangerous, that's why I just assigned a red color. So 5% people are very in a critical situation. We can't save that people. So who are that fellows? So if they are neglecting very much, and if they are their age is very high, like for example 50 to 60, 70, like that is there. Okay, and if the people have already what is that, blood pressure, sugar, BP, so if they have any other type of cancers, they're affecting directly. Okay, so old people are affecting very highly in percent, 5% of people, and we can't save the people. If you are using any advanced technologies, advanced medicines also, we can't get that people. Okay, so that's why we should give, we don't want to go outside much more. If you have anything important one, we can go outside, otherwise no need to go. And don't ask them to go outside who are having some problems, whether that person is a young or elder person. So you should take care about the persons if they have any problems. Okay, so please give awareness to the people, they won't get any type of diseases. Okay, so what are the suggestions I am giving here? Okay, I think we know the suggestions already. Okay, so see here. So you should give, so here see, so you should use a sanitizer. Why we are using a sanitizer? If you are coming outside, okay, you are coming from outside, and maybe you touched any objects, okay, or you shake hand with another people, if they have anything, and any, at least minimum, so definitely we have some bacteria, something is there. Okay, then what will happen if you are giving that hands to another people, or if you are eating anything without washing the hands, then what will happen? So definitely the bacteria will go inside of our body. Okay, so then we can get a COVID-19. Okay, so that's why we should sanitize the hands. So when you're coming from outside, and if you're going outside also, just use the sanitizer, then we can reduce little bit thing. And next one is a mask. Why you want to use the mask? Some people see, they're not wearing a mask directly properly. Okay, they will do like this, and they won't cover the face, nose. So they won't cover sometimes mouth. Okay, so they should cover definitely nose and mouth. Okay, that is only the better thing here when you are wearing the mask. And next one is, social distance is very important because maybe the people are affected, some people are affected, but if you are maintaining a distance, we can avoid the type of things here. Okay, so that's why we want to use this COVID-19 also. For this COVID-19, we can use a social distance format also. Okay, next one is COVID types. So we already seen the symptoms and what are the suggestions we are giving. That's okay, fine. In between, after that also, if you are getting problems, you should take COVID test is definitely okay. One is RT-PCR and another one is chest X-ray images based. Okay, so what is nothing but a RT-PCR? I will tell you here. Okay, so what is the RT-PCR here? So RT-PCR is nothing but it's a rapid test. Okay, so they will take samples from nose and mouth. Okay, so but it's not giving a proper output. Okay, it's not giving a 100% accuracy. So what is the use of the accuracy? Why I'm telling here accuracy? Because you can see some people are not affected also, it's showing that people are affected. Some people are affected with the COVID also, it's not showing that people are affected. Okay, so that's why, so sometimes this rapid test is not good. So you want to go with the 100% accuracy, then you can use chest X-ray images based. Okay, so before going to that, you should know. See, so this is only the rapid test, how they will take samples, so from mouth and from nose. Okay, but that are not good. And after getting that one, so you should maintain a social distance and you should be in a quarantine or isolation. Okay, so quarantine is nothing but we have a home quarantine and hospital quarantine is also there. And if you are going with isolation, so before, if you have any symptoms, you can take your room, one room, single room, and you can stay there. Okay, but if you have a COVID-19, they will assign a quarantine for you. Okay, so that is only that there are different things here. So and you can see we can avoid some things by using a vaccination also, right? So we have a two vaccinations in India, Covaxin and Covishield. And when you are using a Covishield, that's good only, but it's giving some effects. Okay, but if you are using a Covaxin, it won't give anything. So it's a better one. But the thing is, Covaxin is very low actually here. Like we are getting many low cases. Like we don't have a much more vaccine here in Covaxin. We have only the Covishield. So much more thing. But we can use anything. Just go with the Covaxin. Okay. So next one is, so this is only the main important thing in image processing. So why we are using this chest X-ray images and what is the use of the chest X-ray images, I will tell you here. Okay, so now we are taking about the chest X-ray images. So why you want to use a chest X-ray images? We have already the rapid test. Why you want to use this one? Because so if you are going with the rapid test, maybe it won't give a proper output to you. Sometimes it will give a wrong outputs. Accuracy is very less sometimes, okay? But if you're going with chest X-ray images, it will give exact output whether that person is affected with the COVID or not, okay? So this is the chest X-ray images. So like we can take chest X-ray images like this. So you can see in these pictures, some color is highlighted here, right? Like white color, okay? So if the white color is very high, okay, the person is affected with the COVID-19. So the lungs are damaged like that, we can say. Okay, the main thing is why you want to take a chest X-ray images means, so in chest X-ray images of lungs, so that are only damaging nowadays. That's why you should take these X-ray images. Okay, so now we can go with the image processing. Now, till now, we learned about the application. What is that? So you want to identify the COVID-19. So what is the problem and how we are getting the problems, how we can resolve the problem by using chest x-ray images, we discussed, right? But in this, you want to take one format. If you want to identify the person is affected with the COVID or not, you're taking image, that's okay, fine. But how you're getting output, that is only the important. For this, we are using a software as MATLAB, and we are going with the technology as image processing. What is nothing but image processing? Image processing is nothing but, so when you have the images or videos data, you want to process something because, so you're not getting you're not satisfying with your input, okay? You're getting some problems with your input. For example, if you are taking up one snap from your mobile, that is not good. Then what you will do? Definitely will make a changes. Okay, you can filter that image, right? So how we are getting that information and what is the use of that information? Because I'm not satisfying with my input, okay? So that is not my exact solution. I have the picture, that is not exact my solution. I want to clarify my doubt and I want to know what is the solution for this and what is the result I want to know. So that purpose, you just want to go with the processing with the images, okay? So next, we have analog images and digital images also there. Analog is nothing but one-dimensional and digital image is nothing but so two-dimensional or three-dimensional also we can take. So this is only the step if you want to identify the COVID-19. Okay, the first thing is input you want to take. The first one is input and the second one is pre-processing. Next one is the techniques. After that, you can go with the output. Okay, so first we can go with the first option. Here, what is the first option? Input. So when you are selecting input, you can give that input to the techniques directly. But if you are giving directly, maybe sometimes it won't give a proper output also. So that's why you should use the pre-process in between. Okay, for the calculation part. So that's why we are applying before process, that is a pre-process. Okay, after getting the pre-process, you can use a techniques. So what you need exactly, after that you can get the output here, okay? So that is only the process. Okay, so now we can go the first step. So first you should know what is an image. Image is nothing but it's a visual representation of the picture and it will define how many horizontal lines are there and how many vertical lines are there in our picture. So you can see this is only the picture. So we can say picture is nothing but it's a combination of pixels. You can see here each and every box, one box equal to one pixel, P-I-X-E-L, pixel. So if you want to design one pixel, you can take combination of pixels. If you want to design one video, you can take combination of images. Okay. Next. So here we should know about different type of images, colored images, grayscale images and black and white images. So what you are giving, that is an input image. If you want to convert something, you can use a pre-process. In that, we can use these conversions, grayscale conversion and as well as black and white conversion. That is nothing but binary conversion. Okay. Next, you can see for each and every image, how many planes are there? Okay, if you are going with the colored image, so we have three planes that are RGB, and if you are going with the colored image, grayscale image, so we have a only intensity, but in this we don't have an intensity. So if you have intensity also in between zeros and ones only there, that is nothing but black and white. So in image processing, we have a techniques. So these are the main 11 techniques. When you need exactly at the time only, you can use the techniques. Otherwise, you won't use the techniques. So acquisition, enhancement, segmentation, recognition, restoration, compression, diffusion, retrievals, technography, watermarking, and cryptography. Okay, so first one we can discuss. So after completing these techniques, we should know, we can go with the application in a practical way. Okay, the first one is the acquisition. Okay, so what is nothing but acquisition? We are acquiring the input image or video from the set of inputs Okay, for example, you have a 10 or 100 images are there. You want to select one input image from the set of inputs to test whether that person is affected with the COVID or not. You can assign image equalization. The next one is the pre-process. Then why you are using a pre-process? If you have any complexity, so for your process, you can use the pre-process. Okay, here we have the resize, conversion and filtering. So these are the three sub-steps in pre-processing. Okay. The first one is resize. What is the use of the resize? We can increase or decrease the size of the image. Yeah, actually here one person asked, what are the steps involved in pre-processing step, ma'am? So I'm telling to you that. So here in pre-processing step, we have the size, conversion and as well as the filtering process. Okay, so to reduce the complexity, we can use these steps. The first one is resize. Then how you will resize, you can see here. Okay, so for example, you have the image of 256 by 256 image, but I want to make a changes here. I want to increase the size. You can increase the size up to 500 by 500. Okay, if you want to decrease the size, you can decrease the size. Okay, you can see the picture, we are not changing the picture. Okay, we are just changing the size of the picture. So see here. How the picture is displaying here, the same picture is displaying here also, but the size is only the difference. Okay, for example, I can tell you one thing. So you have a inches of different inches of laptops or mobiles or TVs, LED TVs or LCD TVs. Okay, so what is the difference between each and everything? For example, if you are taking 32 inches TV, so the screen is the picture is same here also, okay? But if you are going with the 42 inches, the picture also same, but the size is different, okay? We are not losing any information here when you are using different type of the sizes, but we are just changing the size of the picture, okay? So this is only the resize. And the next one is the conversion, okay? Then what is the use of the conversion here? So why you want to use this conversion in pre-processing step? So, for example, if you are taking a colored picture, in that colored picture, for each and every pixel, I told you, right? Picture is nothing but it's a combination of pixels. If you are taking a colored picture, for each and every pixel, you can see the values of 200 by 200 by 200 like this, okay? So, in practical way, I will show you. Before that, I want to tell about the, some theoretical session about this one. And see, I want to convert from RGB to gray. That is nothing but colored picture to gray picture I want to convert. So, that's why I did here average calculations of my picture. Okay. So how I will calculate the average values? You can see what is the mean value formula. So sum of all values by total number of values. For each and every pixel, how many values are there? 3. So if I want to go with the sum of values by all total number of values means 200 plus 200 plus 200 by 3, I can get a 200. So just like that, I calculated the values and I got here the single values. Okay, so I will show you the picture, then you can easily understand there. And now we got a single values right here in this picture. And I can say, so I got a single values over there. Now I want to convert into either black or white. So how I will convert the black or white? Okay, by using a threshold value. So I want to calculate the threshold value here. So by using this threshold value, I can convert the picture is 0 or 1, black or white. Then how I will take this threshold value means here in this gray value, which value is bigger and which value is very lower. Okay, so take maximum value plus minimum value by 2, then you can get the threshold value. Just compare with the threshold value with each and every pixel value. If the threshold value is 122, so just compare with the threshold value for each and every pixel. Okay, so my threshold value is here 122 and my pixel value is 200. If it is equal or greater, you can assign 1, and if it is less than the threshold value, you can assign 0. 200 is greater than 122. I can assign this is 1. Okay, next one is 141. 141 is greater than 122. So here you can say 122 equal is also there. You can assign a 1. 1. Okay, here you can see 56 is there. Okay, 56 is less than 122. Then what you will do, just assign a 0. Okay, so now we taken here 128 is my threshold value like that. So after getting that one, so I got the values like this, because 128 also less than 122, 122 also less than our threshold value. So that's why I just assigned here the 0. These are the black and white combinations. So next one is the filtering. Okay, before going to the filtering, so I will show you the code for the gray conversion and as well as a black and white conversion. How we converted that one, I will show you. Okay, so now I'm just going with the MATLAB. So before going to this one, I will tell you a little bit introduction about the MATLAB. So MATLAB is nothing but a matrix laboratory. Okay, so why we are using this matrix laboratory? So this is a simple format and where you are searching all tools regarding for the image processing, signal processing, power electronics, the power system, and for the communication, for the antenna based designing part, for 3D animations, we can use this MATLAB. Okay, so now, so what we can do in a MATLAB? So first I want to do the image conversion. Okay, what I'm doing here, so I'm just going to here. So before that, I want to tell something about the MATLAB. So this is a MATLAB format. When you are opening a MATLAB, so first you should install the packages. But when you are installing the packages, you should install all packages what you need exactly here. Okay, so here I want to do the code, so that's why I just gone with the script mode. This is my script mode. And what if we don't convert to black and white now? Some people are asking if we don't convert to black and white, ma'am. Okay, no worries. Actually, based on your requirement, we can convert. So one thing I will tell you. So for example, so I have a 3 parts. Okay, so for example purpose, I will tell you about the black and white. So for example, I have a 3 values. Okay, so actually in colored image I have a 3 values for each and every pixel, but in gray I have a single value. So in black and white I have only either 0 or 1. Which one is better to calculate values, gray or black and white or colored image? In colored image we have lot of 1, right? We can go with the comparison of gray or black and white. Okay, but in gray we have a single values, but if you are going with a black and white, we have a zeros and ones. Okay, for the calculation part and for the multimedia applications, and if you want to find out any edges, okay, so that purpose we can use this black and white conversion. Okay, so now, so this is the script where you are writing the code, anything. So this is the script and this is the command prompt. Here you can see the output values and input values and calculations, and here the current folder. This is nothing but a current directory. This current directory will show us what are the files are available to run the program like that. So till now I didn't use. So what we have already passed one, it will show us that only. And next one is here we have a GUI process also, graphical user interface also there. Then we can go with that also. But I want to show what is the difference between each and everything of pictures. Okay, I'm taking here CLC. So for the purpose of clearing, next, clear all. So now I'm taking the first one is, if you want to go with any comment lines in this MATLAB, you can use this one. So here the first step is what? You want to read the image. Okay, just read the image. Then, so why I'm using this modulus means it's about for the command lines. Okay, next one is I want to go with the pre-process, right? Okay, so the first one is how to read the input image, how to acquire the input image. Next one is pre-process. In that pre-process only, we can use the first one is gray, conversion, black and white conversion, and resize also. Okay, I can do all those things. So first I will read. So here the picture, the first one is I want to read the picture. So I am taking here one variable as img like that. So in that variable I have to store one image. If you want to store the image here, you can use the attribute as im read of that extension name you can give. Okay, I am giving inp.jpg. So but if you are giving directly like this, it won't take. Just give a quote, whether that is a single quote or double quote, just give a quote if you are taking input image. Okay, so I just given quotes, but so you should check with the extension also. And another one is so if you are doing like this directly, if you are giving an input image directly here, so first you should gather all those information. For example, if you are running this program, you should save the program in a same folder. In that folder only you should take input image. If you have an input image in another path, just give the path here. Okay, so now I'm just saving this program. Where I want to save? So in desktop I'm saving with the pract like that. Okay, I just save the program. But so I want to check whether I have a input image or there or not with inp.jpg. So I'm just going with the desktop. I don't have any image here. I have some image here, I think. So I'm just taking this image. I'm just changing with the file name as INP. But you can check with the extension. If I given actually I given like INP.jpg, but here you can see the extension is JFIF. Okay, then what you will do? So come to code and give input variable name, extension name as JF and IF. Next, if you want to display this output, you can use im show. Input. So we should give a window name also. Okay, and which type of the output you want to give, just give that variable name to here. Now you can run the program and you can see the output. Okay, im read okay, JFIF extension is not correctly showing. Okay, if you're not giving a proper extension also, it will shows that one. So you should check with the format also, whether that is correct format or not. Okay, now I'm just running the program. You can see. Okay, then I can give directly. Okay, you should check with the options whether we have the options or not. Okay, so see what I have the picture. I got the picture. Okay, so I have my picture is with the name of INP with the extension name as JFIF, and I just stored that information into certain variable and I'm displaying that one. Okay, if you're running this program, you can see I'm not getting any like a window name here. I'm getting directly figure one. Okay, but I want to give any name means what you will do, you can give directly, but some versions it's not available. So you can give here the title, and you can give any title what you need exactly in that. Okay, I'm giving input. So now I'm just running the program. You can see it's giving an input variable name here. Okay, the title is input what you're giving, and it will display here. Okay, so if you want to display to read after reading the process, you can use like this. But I want to know what are the pixel values of my picture. Okay, if you want to know the pixel values, you can use attribute as imtool. Okay, now I'm just running my program. You can see, so it's running, it's showing busy. So one picture came, again it's showing busy, and we got the output another picture. I given directly im tool. Then what is the use of the im tool is nothing but what you are giving your input image. For that it will take pixel values. It will display the pixel values in downside. You can see in last pixel info like that you are getting, right? You can see I'm just going with my cursor downside pixel info xy rgb. xy is nothing but how many rows are there in your pixel, how many columns are there, that only. You can see it's showing us some box. Okay, but I want to know these pixel values here. Okay, then what you will do, just increase the size And when you are increasing the size, it will show the pixel values for each and every pixel. Wait. See, for each and every pixel, it's showing the values. Okay? So, these are only the pixel values. Not only for this, for video also, we have values like this only. So, this is only the pixel information. So, I have shown this one. So, after that, I want to go with the preview to use the resize. Just use resize attribute and give to whom you want to resize the part. So I have an image in img variable. I have to share the same. I have to change the size of information. So directly you can give here. Otherwise you can save the size into certain variable and give that variable to here also. So here I am directly giving 256. Let's space 256. Okay. Now, if you want to display the output, you can display. I am taking directly im tool of, because if you are taking like a im show, it will give output, but it will take too much of time. So that's why I am just completing up to this. Okay, it's showing the values here. You can see after completing that one. So see. So the size is changed. Previously what is the size, and now you can see what is the size. The size changed, right? How you are changing the size? By using resize attribute. The resize is done. So now I can go with the conversion. img gray conversion. Okay. img gray I just given a variable name. So now I want to convert img to gray. Directly you can give this attribute. Image to gray. And to whom you want to change, just give that variable to name to here. So I have the picture of img, what I have at starting time, giving that one because the size is very high. So now I'm taking im show, I want to display, but I can take directly im tool because I can see pixel values and as well as my picture. So that's why I'm giving here, just give that variable name to here, img gray. Okay, so now I'm just running the program. Just you can see, so this is my first picture, this is a pixel information, this is resize picture. Okay, it's showing the error. Okay, so not img, sorry, I forgot that. So rgb to gray, because you want to convert rgb to gray, na? So colored picture to gray conversion I am doing. So now I am just running the program, you can see. So this is colored picture, this is resized picture, and this is the gray conversion picture. Can you see this picture, what you observed here? So what you observed here, you can see. Okay, so this is my gray picture. If you want to see the picture, you can see the picture here. So this is the gray picture. The full color is changed here. So here you want to see the values. Downside you can see X and Y, rows and columns. And it's given here intensity. When you are making the changes, like moving the cursor here, based on that intensity value will give. So now you can go to the pixel value of second one. And it will drag this area. Now you can see. So previously we have a 3-3 values, now we have only the single value because we just converted into the gray conversion. Okay, and now I can go with the black and white. Okay, so imbw I am taking. You can take any type of the variables, but don't take any keywords or numbers like that. Okay, so because we are using here the C language. Okay, now I will take rgb to bw because of black and white I need, right? That purpose. So just give that variable name to here, img, and now you can give im tool. Then what is the use of the im tool? You can display the image directly and you can see the pixel values over there. So that's why I'm giving here imbw. Because why I'm giving here in braces, because if what you need exactly the output, just give that variable name to here, that's it. Okay, now I'm just running the program, you can see. RGB B. Doesn't take Y. We have AMG variable, undefined function as RGB. Wait a minute, it's not taking here. Correct only now. So actually the thing is, you wanted to make a changes in that, exactly the variable name, that's why it's not showing. Okay, in our code we can see what is what, because time is already done. So now I just want to go with the COVID-19 detection here in this PPT. So these are the filters what you are giving here. So what is the use of the filter means, we can remove the noise from the images. And the next one is, we are taking a segmentation process also. For this purpose, it will make a changes in a edges, and after that, if you want to recognize the features, you can use these many things. Now we are using a GLCM, and this is a block diagram for that. So based on this, we can go with the output. Deep learning algorithms. So it will extract the features very deeply, and it will give a proper output. So that's why we are going with this one. So now I will show the code. Okay, just copy the first. Next, come to MATLAB. Okay, so I have the code files here. I'm just gone with the GG. Now you can see in this GUI. So you have to take first how many objects you need each and everything. And first one is what? You want to select the input image, right? So I just selected the input image. Next, I want to go with the pre-process step. I just completed the pre-process step. Next, the main step here, you want to compare the input. You are there, sir. So please fill the feedback form, and you can take attendance, and you can get the certificates from this session. Okay, thank you.